This is a 64-year-old patient presented 2 weeks earlier with significant subarachnoid hemorrhage and referred to us with a suspected anterior communicating artery aneurysm. And this was confirmed on a CT angio, which we did just before the procedure 1 day earlier. And it showed this reasonably wide neck aneurysm and the anterior communicating artery level. It's kind of at the junction of A1, A2, predominantly from the right side. And this is the left A1. So it is partially involving the anterior communicating level as well as A1, A2 junction on the right side. We brought the patient for an angio. We prepared her with antiplatelets just in case that we need to do stent-assisted coiling, because it's a very small aneurysm and it had a reasonably wide neck. Now, she's got a lot of tortuosity in her vessels, cervical internal carotid artery, as well as a petrous or pre-petrous internal carotid artery. So initially, this is the angio, right internal carotid artery injection, left side as well. And you can see that the wall, it's a side wall kind of aneurysm, more on the right side. So initially I started by wanting to try at least simple coiling technique, which sometimes I do. Sometimes the anatomy it turns out to be easier than what we think, but not in this particular patient. So I tried to place the tip of the microcatheter inside the sac of the aneurysm, and this is the microcatheter here in the sac, but I was not able to place the coil to stay within the sac of the aneurysm. I tried to cross to place a stent from A1 to A2 from the right side, but due to the anatomy and the very shallow small aneurysm, it was a bit difficult for me to do that. And I was worried that the microcatheter and the wire keeps on going to the sac, and this is a recently ruptured aneurysm. So what I did, I came from the opposite side, I crossed from the left side, and I placed a stent across the neck of the aneurysm, but from A1 to A2, from A1 on the left side to A2 on the right side. And then I came from the right side again, and I placed an X stenting technique, and then I did the coiling through the X stent. So then I came from the right side to the left side, placed a second stent, and then I placed the coils in the sac of the aneurysm. Coils I used were just a 1.5 millimeter coil, 3D, and then I placed a second one. So these are the stents. This is one stent coming from left A1 to right A2, and then a second stent coming from right A1 to left A2 over here, and the coiling technique.